Harmony and Brad, welcome to your wedding day. We are here this afternoon to celebrate with Harmony and Brad as they commit themselves to one another through marriage and to share their recognition and appreciation for the love for one another. Harmony and Brad, speaking on behalf of everyone here today, we feel so fortunate and blessed to have each of you in our lives and have witnessed your relationship grow to the fundamental life partnership it is today. Who would have thought working together at Groundies would ultimately lead you both to this point in your lives, where you are standing here with the love of your life, ready to make this huge commitment to each other? Ultimately, as both of you worked together, there was one compulsory company rule that all employees had to adhere to, and that was no fraternization with fellow employees. So with this rule in mind, your relationship was kept on the down low as both of you were reminded to never shit where you eat. Harmony, I believe it was you who made the moves on Brad first. Brad, when Harmony kissed you for the first time, you gratefully commended her for the courage of making the first move, because it's scary, right? I mean, what if she freaked out and ran for the hills? Your first initial date was instigated by Brad via Facebook Messenger. Upon arrival, Brad greeted you, Harmony, with a rose and a crystal clam, of which, Harmony, you still have to this day. Your relationship blossomed over the years coming, and your passion for adventure was equally shared. Your first anniversary together was celebrated overseas in Bali, but your true love was camping. Many a time a tent was propped up at Stradbroke, Inskip, Rainbow, Gordon Country, Kenilworth, and Cruiser Park. Let's take a moment to celebrate your biggest achievements. On the 31st of May 2020, your little man Mason was born. Your little family has now grown from a duo to now a trio. So many exciting firsts have taken place these last few months. You both have watched Mason transition from a newborn to a very excitable, happy little man, taking part in all the milestones from the first time he sat up right through to the moment he could pull himself up and walk aided by one of his favourite toys. But there is one particular moment, and this is the day Brad proposed to our beautiful Harmony. Both of you were super excited about taking a trip away together to celebrate your anniversary. So you booked a house through Airbnb to celebrate your next few nights away. This trip was anticipated with much excitement. Not only were you both excited about spending a few nights together, but Harmony, you were doing a little happy dance, as this place had a bar. Unlike home, there just isn't one. So thoughts of long, hot bubble baths occupied your mind. So when it was time to have said bubble bath, you probably noticed a few things. Firstly, there were water restrictions. Bummer, but that's okay. He's going to notice a sneaky bath. Secondly, there was no plug. That's okay. We can cut up a thong and fashion a plug out of that. Bingo, that worked. But thirdly, the hot water ran out, tarnishing any hopes of a long, relaxing bath. Another thing about this weekend was, Harmony, you were somewhat under the weather, suffering from a rather bad bout of the flu. But you still soldiered on like the true champion you were. The next day it was decided that you would go on a hike and explore the local surroundings. A bottle of champagne was purchased to celebrate the time you both got to spend with each other. After a short while exploring the sights, you fell upon a spot with your view at the top of a hill. It was here that you both stopped for a while, popped that champagne and enjoyed the view. Turns out the champagne was a bit gross. But thank goodness for your cold, Harmony, as you weren't able to taste the champagne to its entirety. It was at this moment, Brad, you popped that big question. Harmony, will you marry me? But at this same moment, Harmony, you were overcome with a coughing fit, and after you pulled yourself together, a prompt, bright, excitable yes was conveyed. Which ultimately leads us to where we all stand today, Harmony and Brad's wedding day. So, without further ado, Let's get both of you hitched. It is my delightful pleasure and privilege to have been asked to present Harmony and Brad's wedding ceremony as their marriage celebrant, and to be able to mark this very special moment in time with them. You have all been invited here as dear family and friends to be a part of this moment, and I ask you all to be witness with me to the marriage between Harmony and Brad. I am duly authorised by law to solemnise marriages according to law. Before you are joined in marriage in my presence and in the presence of all these witnesses, I am to remind you of the solemn and binding nature of the relationship into which you are now both about to enter. Marriage, according to law in Australia, is the union of two people to the exclusion of all others, voluntarily entered into for life. Harmony, will you take Brad to be your lawful wedded husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only on to him for as long as you both shall live. Brad, will you take Harmony to be your lawful wedded wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only on to her for as long as you both shall live. Harmony and Brad, you are now about to make promises to one another. Today, these marriage vows and beautiful words represent even more beautiful intentions. You'll find that as you live these vows over the years, investing your time, your love and commitment to one another, the happy times will be twice as happy because there will be someone to share these special times with you. And when life gets a bit tough, it will only be half as bad because there will be someone there by your side. Harmony, I will get you to say what I am saying right now. I call upon the persons here present to witness that I, Harmony Grace Brains, take thee, Brad William McMurdo, to be my lawful wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better for worse, for richer for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do us part. This is my solemn vow and promise. Brad, if I could get you to repeat the words after me. I call upon the persons here present. To witness that I, Brad William McMurdo, take thee, Harmony Grace Baines, to be my lawful wedded wife.
Be my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health,
sickness and in health,
until death do us
part.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
And I would now like to call upon our ring bearer.
Well done.
A wedding ring can mean many things. It symbolises the promises and vows two people make to one another and demonstrates a continuing bond and commitment underpinning their marriage. It will become one of your most treasured and valued possessions. Harmony, please repeat after me as you place the ring on Brad's finger. I, Harmony, give this ring to you, Brad, as a symbol of the love that unites us today. This wedding ring represents my love for you, the commitment we share for our future together, and the vows we have made to one another here today. Brad, please repeat after me as you place the ring on Harmony's finger. I, Brad, give this ring to you, Harmony, as a symbol of the love that unites us today. This wedding ring represents my love for you, the commitment we share for our future together, and the vows we have made to one another here today. I invite you to take a moment to appreciate each other and the friendship, admiration, respect, and love that has brought you here today. Think about the happiness you are both feeling right now and let that register in your hearts and in your minds. When you look back on this day in years to come, let this be the moment that you remember clearly, the moment that stands out above all others, because this is the moment in which I take the greatest of pleasures in letting you know you are now husband and wife. Now you better have a really big kiss to seal that deal. Brad, you may now kiss your beautiful bride. Family and friends, please may I ask that you put your hands together and let out the loudest of cheers, as I would now like to take the honour in presenting our newly married couple, Mr. and Mrs. McMurdo.
Decades passed, then along comes Roundy, Their story starts at this workplace. He was told not to look and no face to face. But once her employment had gone and expired, he took a chance. No boss, no rules, that's all he required. With his big flashy ute and little drift car, this young lady thought, this man will go far. Now these days, all those cars are getting gone, and it's getting even harder to pay the bills at the salon. Through all of the hard times and all of the tears, even sometimes after a few too many beers, you know that between you there is an unbreakable unity, and besides it's too late to leave, you miss your opportunity. I understand that sometimes it can be like an unbearable itch, which I suppose is a nice way of saying you can be a bitch.
Yes,
let's be honest, those shoulders are so wide and so broad. You'll be right, your memories together cannot be ignored. Now to bring this up, on your wedding day is probably quite controversial, but from what I've heard, you ain't husband material. It may have annoyed you when she got her face inserted, but remember, you're not innocent, all those ciggies you murdered. We all have our flaws, and nobody's perfect. And I know after all of it, it is definitely worth it. Because the love between Brad and Harmony Gray created the perfect little man we all call Mace. I'm starting to ramble, so I'll bring it to an end. I love you both, and nothing I said was supposed to offend. So I hope after all this, your feeling is still the same. Because I need you back at work on Monday. I need someone to blame.
Thank you.